Today, as I promised you from the previous video, I'm gonna explain how I deconstruct Nine Inch Nails' closer track on Ableton Live 10. And I will also give you the Ableton Live pack that I made for free to download. It is basically a MIDI arrangement and customized set of sounds emulating Nine Inch Nails' closer. The reason why I chose this track is because this track got a sentimental value to me on how I develop my soundscapes, and it's kinda influential to me. I use only built-in sounds and effects in Ableton Live to recreate the sounds of 9 Inch Nails' closer, so I didn't use any VSTs or plugins to recreate this track. So, as a start, let's have a listen to 9 Inch Nails' closer. So that was the track that we're gonna deconstruct today. It was kind of pretty cool, intimate, vivid, erotic video though. You can see how the anger and self-hatred on the video. So anyways, let's move on to the fun facts. It was produced by Flood and Trent Reznor. If you don't know who Flood is a British post-punk and an alternative rock record producer and audio engineer. Flood's list of work includes Project with New Order, U2, and of course 9 Inch Nails, The Piché Mode, Gary Numan, The Charlatans, 30 Seconds to Mars, Nick Cave and the Bad Seeds, PJ Harvey, Foals, Orbital, Sigur Rós, The Smashing Pumpkins, The Killers, White Lies, War Pain, and EOB. EOB is the name of the side project band from the guitarist of Radiohead, which is Edward O'Brien. And he got also a collaboration with Brian Eno, And also, in 2006, his work with U2 led to his sharing of the Grammy Award for Album of the Year for How to Dismantle an Atomic Bomb. Vocal by Trent Reznor, the founder of Nine Inch Nails. The album was their second LP, which is called The Downward Spiral. It was released on May the 30th, 1994. It was like 27 years ago. Record label under Nothing, TVT, Interscope, and Atlantic. It was recorded at L'Epic. L'Epic is in LA, a famous studio. The record plant and AN Studios. The style of this music is industrial rock and alternative rock. And the original Nine Inch Nails members are Trent Reznor and Atticus Ross. And now we're gonna move on to their reference. I got this reference from whosampled.com. The first reference is a bass drum from Iggy Pop's Nightclubbing. And the second one is the Multiple Elements by Roxy Music, Take a Chance with Me. The samples were produced using two Akai S1100 samplers, each with an expander, essentially making up four samplers. The samples were then combined with beats produced by a Roland R70 drum machine. And now I'm gonna explain how I deconstruct Nine Inch Nails Closer on Ableton Live 10 without using any VSTs or audio plugins. I only use what's already inside on Ableton without any further downloads or external downloads. I use instruments, audio effects, and media effects. I use analog, sampler, simpler, and operator for the audio effect. I use amp, auto filter, compressor, EQ8, EQ3, overdrive, phaser, and vocoder. For the MIDI effects, I use scale and velocity. Now let's go on to the session view. I created drums, lead groove, lead bass, syntronic synth, eerie strings, high strings, guitar, widened guitar, and a sub bass. Okay, I'm gonna explain you one by one. But first of all, we're gonna start from the drum track. The drum track. The drum track consists of kick 1, kick 2, snare 1, snare 2, Close hi-hat, right. Okay, I use a sampler for the kick one and a compressor. This is the pattern that I made, and let's go to the kick two. I also use a sampler and a compressor. I put the threshold down to -24.7 decibels. These are the patterns, and snare one I use simpler and compressor, and snare two I use simpler, compressor, EQ8. I killed down a bit the low. And let's move to the hi-hat. I use sampler. It's basically a close hi-hat. Let's rename it to close hi-hat. And let's move on with rides. I use sampler as well for the ride. And let's move on to the lead groove. Okay, I made the sound from my synth and then turned it into an audio clip. I made a Moog sound out of it and made it into a sample, and the RoboSynth that I made, I use sampler, and EQ8 as usual. I killed the low filter a bit. I used reverb and then compressor. I lowered the threshold into 21.3 decibels. And octaves modulator and a phaser. Now the bass. The bass, I use operator. And put auto filter. And I say chain it with the kick one, the audio from the kick one, and put the threshold into -21 decibels. Let's move on to the Synthronic synth. I created the MIDI pattern first. Start from C2 and E3. And then I created a sample using synth and made it audio clip. And use EQ to lower the low filter a bit. So it's gonna sound like a sequencer. And I pan it all in to the left. Now to the electronic style piano, I duplicated it, it's the same thing as the first one, but this one I pan it totally right to the right. So it's left and right pan for the Synthronic synth pattern. And the eerie strings. The eerie strings I create with a sampler
and put some EQ8, LO the low filter a bit, and smoother in the high end, and I use reverb. It's basically from C. The high strings. I use simple for the high strings and put it into an instrument rack. It's from a violin. Use EQ3. Reverb. These are the chords. And then the guitar, I use an analog to create the sound. I put it as a strangler lead because it sounds like distorted. It sounds like a string, people. I put a vocoder for the Y effect. And the amp, I use a heavy width cabinet to make it sounds heavier. And these are the pattern. Start with F and A sharp, F, A sharp. And the wider guitar. Okay. I use analog. It's basically the same thing as the first guitar. Put an EQ8 on it, lower the low filter a bit, and I panned them left and right. They're basically the same, but yeah. So it sounds more stronger between left and right ear when you're using headphone or an active speaker. And it won't peak. And then the last one is the sub bass. I use operator for the sub bass. And these are the chords. F. It's basically totally just F. A lower F. And that's it. Let's move on to arrangement view and record this all.
Yeah.
So that's pretty much it, and you guys can download this for free and play around with that. Cheers!
Cheers.